Terminator, Gladiator, Hector and Vector. Oops. Terminator, Gladiator, Hector and Vector. What do they have in common? Write your opinions in comments below. A couple of years ago, I asked my friend what Vector was. He said that it comes from the word victory. Firstly, I didn't believe him. Then I started to believe, because mastering vectors was a part of a victory. So, as you have guessed, today's topic is vectors. To understand vector, we have to first know what scalar is. Scalar is a quantity that has only magnitude. Examples of scalar quantities include mass, time, speed, distance, volume, and etc. But vector has not only magnitude, but also direction. Examples of vectors include velocity, displacement, acceleration, force, and etc. Maybe some of you thought that velocity and speed, distance and displacement were the same things. No, they are not. Now, let's consider distance and displacement example. Distance is the space between two objects, which can be measured on a scale, and which describes the magnitude alone. But on the other hand, displacement is the change in the position of an object. In animation, car changes its position to the east. If you notice it, I emphasize direction as well. So, why vectors are so important, and why do we study them? Because many quantities used in physics are vectors. The most important thing in vectors are their directions. If you add or subtract vector quantities without taking into account their direction, you will get results incorrect. In vectors, arrow shows the direction, and the length of arrow shows the magnitude of a vector. Here, we see that the magnitude of B is larger than A because of their length and their directions are same. Vector multiplication and division. If a vector is multiplied by a positive scale, here it is 2, its magnitude is increased by that amount. But in division, if it is divided by a positive scale, its magnitude is decreased by that amount. Here it is divided by 2. When you multiply and divide these vectors with a negative scale, the magnitude will be the same, but the direction will change. Addition of vectors are also very easy, and to do that, we generally use two rules. The first rule is parallelogram. Here we add two vectors, and the first thing that we do is connect their tails. After that, draw a parallel line to each other from their heads and draw a straight line to their intersection, which will be the resulting vector. Repeat the same process in this example too. Connect tails, draw parallels, and draw a straight line to their intersection. Second one is triangular rule. In this example, we add vector A to B. Let me write head to tail here, you will understand why I wrote that. First way of doing this is connecting tail of B to the head of A, then drawing a straight line from tail to head. Second way is connecting tail of A to the head of B, then drawing a straight line from tail to head. As you see here, both of the resultant vectors are equal in terms of direction and magnitude. Collinear addition is the special case addition where vectors are parallel to each other and we just simply add them. As you see here in these examples, the resultant vectors are equal to addition of vectors. Simple as that. Subtraction of vectors are very similar to addition of vectors. The only difference is that you change the direction of a vector that you are subtracting. Here I subtract vector B, so I change its direction to the opposite side and write plus sign between them. And then I can solve this vector subtraction by using parallelogram law, and also I can solve them by using triangle rule. It's no surprise that all of the resultant vectors will be the same. Let's solve an example related to vectors. A man pulls a box with the force of 500 Newton and a car with the force of 1 kilonewton. Let's assume that ground is frictionless. I will draw a free body diagram to simplify this figure. I will assume that the right side is positive, the right plus sign here, the left side is a negative. By adding them together, I get positive 500 Newton, which means that box will move to the right side with the force of 500 Newton. In this example, both man and car pull in the same direction with the forces of 500 Newton and 1000 Newton respectively. The resultant force will be 1500 Newton in the positive direction, meaning that box will move to the right side with the force of 1500 Newton. Simple as that. Bum 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 b